All right, next we have Raj Kumar. He is going to take the next 15 minutes to tell us everything you need to know about machine learning and testing.
Yes.
No pressure.
Thank you. Yeah, very good afternoon to all of you. I'm Raj Kumar. Before I start my presentation, I would like to thank Google for having given me an opportunity to share my ideas with you all. Thank you, Google. Why it's not coming? Oh, it's coming, okay. Yeah, so this is my topic. Machine learning algorithm for setting up mobile test environment. The agenda of my talk is about me. I would like to give you a small introduction about myself. Mobile test environment, device management and its challenges. Then we'll see the machine learning algorithm for selecting the devices. Then we'll have a Q&A followed by a demo, okay? I'm Raj Kumar Jogi Bhojan. You can call me Raj. I've been working as a principal consultant at Wipro Technologies, Boston, MA. I have 2 decades of experience, both in academics and IT. I'm a research scholar, published many technical papers, and filed a couple of patents. I also worked as a test architect, QA manager, corporate trainer, scrum master, and test consultant. Yeah. Now, before we start the test automation environment, let us see what are the important factors to be considered. If you look at the slide, it talks about OS platform. So what type of platform I'm going to use it? Whether I'm going to use the Mac or Windows or the Unix, Linux, whatever, which platform I'm going to use it? Network environment, is it a 2G, 3G, 4G, or LTE? Mobile testing tools, there are say about 20 to 30 tools are there. So which tool am I going to use it? Then comes the testing types. What type of testing am I going to do it in my environment? Regression, security, functional, or secure, or say the performance. So what type of testing am I going to do it? Now, along with that, we also need to think about the emulators, simulators, the application to be tested, AUT. Along with that, again, we need to think about the devices. So which type of device am I going to use it for my mobile test environment? If you look at the slide, all these things are countable except the devices. So which device am I going to select for my regression suite? What is the combination of devices for my testing environment? Then comes that slide leads us to talk about the mobile device management challenges. So if you look at the challenges, the first challenge what we face is each and every year, the devices getting released, hundreds and thousands of devices are getting released every year. And devices getting refreshed every 12 to 14 months, 24 months. Then new capabilities, each and every year we are getting additional capabilities like camera, GPS, orientation, voice, so many things getting added every year. Then it comes the multiple carriers, network switching, disconnected use, throughput, latency. So these are also, again, challenges. On top of all these things, it is very, very expensive to buy the devices for my own testing, for everyday testing. If I want to buy, say, about 100 devices for my testing, it's very expensive. I need to allocate, say, about 15 to 20% of the project budget for my devices alone. So the next one comes, one second, sorry. Sorry. Yeah, there are 400 network operators throughout the world. So each and every network operators, they have their own technologies. CDMA, GSM, LTE, they have their own technologies. That's again a challenge for testing folks. Then comes the hardware challenges, like a processing speed, memory, communication protocols. Then comes non-availability of devices. Some devices, whichever I am able to see it in the US, I'm not able to see it in India or China. Some devices are more popular in India, but those devices I'm not able to see it in the US. So the non-availability of devices, that's again the challenge. The last challenge, what I've discussed here is the tight deadline. Today, ABC company is launching a new device. Within say about 2 weeks of time, XYZ is launching another device to capture the market. So these are all the challenges we face in our selecting the devices. So with all these challenges, how am I going to select the device? What are the key criteria for selecting the devices? Does my device compatible with all type of mobile testing? What is the permutation and combination of devices for my regression testing? What is the device market share? What about the user ratings and reviews? Now, so these questions are not that easy to answer. So what we have decided in this slide talks about how are we going to select the devices from a pool of hundreds and thousands of devices. If I ask the same question to my children, I'm giving you say about 10 different mobile devices. So which device are you going to select? My child used to say, Papa, it's very easy, Pa. I thought the child is very creative, so she will give some answer. She said, Inky, Pinky, Ponky, Father had a donkey, donkey died, father cried. And she's asking, expecting me to cry. Father cried, father cried. So that's what we do not know what type of devices we have to select for our own testing when you have a large number of devices. Should I have to go for the iOS? Should I have to go for the Android? Should I have to go to the BlackBerry? Which one I have to select? Right? In Android alone, we have 24,000 devices, plus iOS devices, plus BlackBerry, plus Windows. So how am I going to select for my regression suite? How am I going to classify these devices? How am I going to select the right combination for my devices? So we thought, why don't we go for machine learning algorithm? So you all know that machine learning algorithm, there are so many algorithms. In fact, I'm talking to the Google place. Google itself is a pioneer in machine learning algorithms, right? TensorFlow, deep learning. And similarly, the Wipro is also doing a lot of focus on the machine learning and the AI tools. So here, we have decided to go for decision support algorithm as well as the random forest algorithm. So if you look at the decision algorithm, so we have taken some 120 samples out of 15,000 samples, and we have done some of the research like this, and actually, I'll show you the next slide. This is our sample data. These are the classification graphs. Now, this is the demo screenshot I've taken from. What did we do? First, we have imported all the required library for our prediction. Then we loaded the data from the CSV file. So this CSV file we have named as device underscore demo.csv. Then we have cleaned. Just now we saw NaN, so you will get a lot of NaN. So we have to clean the data. So all this data we have cleaned. And then we started to use the decision tree classifier. So when you use the decision tree classifier along with the features, so the features, you know, we had to say about 7 different columns. We got this type of a decision tree. Now, if you look at the decision tree here, the topmost part, you have a Gini value. So Gini is nothing but it's an entropy level. And if it comes to know, there are samples there. We have taken 10, and 4,6 has been divided. And the Gini value, if you look at the Gini value, it comes down, no? It goes lower and lower. It is coming at the 0.0. That means there's no more impurities. So the first level, it will be like a 0.48. As it goes down lower and lower, it comes to 0.0. That means you need not go further decision. So there, the growth of the tree stops there. So there are some type of disadvantage of the decision tree. So we thought of doing a random forest algorithm with the same data. So if you look at here, the random classifier with the same data, the 10 values we have taken, you can see the attributes, the variables, like OS, memory, manufacturer. These are the generic data, generic attributes we have taken. And now, at the last column, you can see it's a selection. That means, based on my historical data, I am going to select these devices. The first one may be the Google Pixel. The second one is the iOS device. So the first one I am going to select, the second one I'm not going to select, third one I'm going to select. It's like that. So based on our project, based on our data, we can give our own training data, or we can set the last column selection. So once you made the selection here, you will get the prediction value. It's like this, see? Now, if you look at this, is 1, 6, 4, 3, 5, 0. That's the third row. We have taken that row. So the based on the existing value, it gives you the value called 1. I can show it in my laptop itself because of some technical hitch, you know, glitches, we are not able to do it now on the screen. But it is giving the value called 1. The second one, if you look at this, you know, that's two, that is another value, another row of data we have taken, and based on the random forest estimator, it is random forest classifier, it is giving it the value called 0. That means it is you are not going to select the value. Then what we did, we have selected the same set of data with a new data. Instead of 64 gigabytes, we are giving 128 new data we gave, and it's giving us number 1. That means it can be selected. So now, based on the 10 values, we have arrived at this type of prediction. Now, based on our projects, whichever project we do, what we can do, we can train our data, and based on the training data, we'll be able to select the right set of devices. Now, in my results, I've selected just only one device. But the same thing what we can do, we can make like a set of devices. At 20, number 20 or 30 number of devices we can put together in the same random forest or decision tree, and you can predict the values. Now comes the main takeaway from my presentation is, the first one is predicted value is equal to the set of recommended devices for the regression testing. We can leverage the machine learning algorithm for identifying the right number of devices, the right number, the right combination of devices. The second one is ultimately it will reduce the time and cost. Third one is we will also be able to overcome the device-based issues. by selecting the right devices by using the machine learning algorithm. So as I already told you, at present I have used the decision tree and my random algorithm, but we can use any type of algorithms. It's not necessary that we have to stick only these two algorithms. Okay, that's all. Thank you so much once again. If there is any questions, please let me know.
Very good. I think my question, I would want to know, how did the machine learning prediction compare to your daughter's way of choosing?
Yeah.
Okay, that wasn't a real question.
So again, that was a tip of, I need to do a lot of research in that. Yeah.
Let me try and get the questions on screen. But in the meantime, does anyone in the room have a question?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, I have a question because I came from the statistic background, and the random forest and the decision tree, I'm pretty familiar with.
Okay.
Because the data volume is really not. I think it's really not suitable for to use the decision tree and for those. But anyway, yeah, it's a good idea. But I just have some thoughts on it. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. No, I didn't get that. No. Yeah. Come again. Yeah.
Oh.
I'm sorry. I didn't get you though. You said that a decision tree cannot be used for this type of analysis?
Yeah, because actually, I work on the data mining for a while.
Okay.
And I kind of feel, for the data volume on, mobile device is really, small. There's lots of noise when you training the model. So I doubt for this.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. That's why the decision tree cannot be used for a small volume of the data. That's why we have switched to the random forest algorithm. It is not necessary that we have to stick to one algorithm. This is an idea. We have already implemented a POC, and we can use any type of algorithm. It's the data mining, and it need not to be only for the large volume data, right? We can also it is also applicable for the small set of data. Yeah.
Okay. And since that was a lightning talk,
okay,
we're out of time. But yes, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Round of applause.